Gifford, didn't you tell them?
Why, not yet.
Hello? What?
That I've been in pictures.
That movie star?
Not the Lola Burns that we've been reading about.
Yes, that's right. But you see, I can explain all of that.
Have you read the papers recently?
I haven't seen a paper since I've been here. Why?
Linda, I'm feeling suddenly faint. Please take me to my room.
Pardon me.
Oh, Mrs. Middleton, please.
You'll excuse me, I'm sure.
But Mrs. Middleton...
Lola, let me handle this.
Oh, but you've got to make her realize that I didn't...
Now, you go to your room and wait for me to phone. I'll smooth everything over. I know Father and Mother better than you
do. Oh, please make them understand, won't you?
Certainly, darling.
Something we said...
No, you didn't mean anything, Pop. Come on, let's go back to my hotel and wait. Gifford was right. He can handle everything.
Yes, certainly, daughter.
Listen, Lola. I saw him give you the high and mighty chill over there, and if there's anything I can do, I... You know, I was a little tight last night, and... If you're really in love with this guy, why, I'd be only...
Just never speak to me again.
Gifford didn't say whether a little difficulty had been all ironed out.
No, he just said to come over right away. Oh, here it is, 92.
I'm telling you, Mr. and Mrs. Middleton, that's the way it
is.
The girl is
14... Mrs. Middleton, don't believe a word he says.
I most assuredly don't.
You see? You see what it is when you come up against decent, respectable people?
Well, wait a minute. You don't get it. I'm on your side. I've been trying to tell them that all that publicity was my fault. Of course, I don't agree with you about your boyfriend here, but I don't see the percentage in your taking it on the chin if it's going to interfere with your happiness.
Well, reputable newspapers can't be hoaxed as easily as all that.
And where there's smoke, there's fire.
Oh, but it's all true, Mrs. Middleton. He was discharged for it, weren't you, Spade?
Why, sure. Don't you see, Mrs. Middleton, the girl must be okay to have a termite like myself trying to bore holes in her character and still be the idol of 110 million people.
A public character. Displaying
all you need to do is explain that you are responsible for all of those stories. If it's pictures that are worrying you, Mrs. Middleton, I'm out of them.
No, it isn't only pictures. The Middleton name has to be considered. Our bloodline dates back to Bunker Hill. I'll have you know, sir, that one of my ancestors stood with Christopher Columbus on the poop deck of the Mayflower.
Gifford, what do you say?
What can I say?
You mean...
I think it best to forget the whole thing, don't you?
Are you forgetting all those... beautiful things you said to me.
Lover's brawl in Lola Burns' home. I guess that sort of line suits you. I'm afraid I've been rather a chump.
You mean you're going to stand by your father and mother?
Certainly. I've done very well so far in abiding by their wishes.
Gifford, you see, is a Middleton.
Gifford's a sap. That's what Gifford is. I'd give him away with a spray of horseradish. I wouldn't be caught dead with him in a duck boat.
Please.
And if you're a lady and they're gentlemen, I'm Amy Simple McHutton on a raft.
Oh.
You can take your Bostons and your Bunker Hills and your bloodlines and stuff a codfish with them.
Oh.
And then you know what you can do with the codfish.
Oh.
Come on.
Come, daughter, get in the car. We're well rid of scum like that.
Say, sis, shall I go back and bust him in a bugle?
Yeah.